Dr. Ari Dukmajian here with another episode of Spine Scams Exposed, specifically talking about insurance companies not paying for medically necessary treatments like spine surgery. Here we have a patient named Nicole who's posting on Facebook, and I'm reacting to that post. She says, "I see my doctor today and we're putting together another appeal. This will make my third appeal to my insurance company because they're denying her surgery." So if you look over here off to the right side, you can actually see on her CAT scan of her spine is pretty badly messed up in her neck. She basically has bad bone spurs that have formed behind the discs and are crushing her spinal cord. The spinal cord is inside this little canal here, and her spinal cord is just getting smashed. This is like urgent surgery is necessary. We gotta get this fixed. This patient's going paralyzed from something pinching the spinal cord in the neck. So I agree the surgery needs to be done. Myself as a neurosurgeon, it's my opinion it needs to be done to prevent her from going paralyzed. But this is her third appeal to her insurance company who's denied her surgery. So why is this a spine scam? Because insurance companies aren't being hired and paid to deny your medical care or decide whether or not you need medical care. Their job is to pay for your medical care. But insurance companies have found it far more profitable to deny paying for surgeries and treatments than to actually pay for them. See, they used to make billions of dollars a year in profit when they paid for people's medical care, but they found that by denying and not paying for treatments, they can make tens of billions, if not hundreds of billions. So their profit margins have gone up over the years as they deny more and more treatments. Here's a perfect example of a patient who's about to go paralyzed from bone spurs crushing her spinal cord. Her neurosurgeon wants to fix this immediately. As a matter of fact, they're on their third appeal. And those appeals take weeks and weeks to submit, review, and get a response for them. So basically, the insurance company is dragging this process out, hoping that the patient gives up. And guess what, folks? About 95% of patients do give up. They give up on the appeal process. They never go any further. But people are starting to catch on, and they're starting to realize insurance companies are the bad guys. Insurance companies are trying to get between the doctor and the patient and block the care so that they don't have to pay for the care. I just want to make you all aware of these scenarios so you're aware that when your doctor recommends a medication for you or a treatment needs to be done or even a diagnostic test, go with your doctor's recommendation. You may have to fight your insurance company, but you're fighting for your own health, and your health is all that matters. Thanks. I'm Dr. Ari Dukmajian with Duke Spine Institute.